Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make pozole or the pork and hominy stew soup so I can give you the ingredients. So for the pozole, we're going to need the pork butt cut in chunks and also some of the pork spine. Okay, this is about 5 pounds total. Or you can use chicken if you like. And also we're going to need some dry chilies. I have chile guajillo, chile ancho, and chile puya. You can use either or, you know, it's up to you. But it's like 4 of each. And also a few bay leaves. And if you want to get it a little more spicy, you can also use some chipotle peppers or pasilla or chile de árbol, okay? This is going to be just a few, not too much. And also, if you want to get it more spicier, this is the chile piquin, okay? So you can substitute the chilies that you like. But if you don't want it too spicy, just go with the guajillo and put about 6 of them. And also we're gonna need a half an onion, about 4 garlic cloves, some dry oregano or fresh oregano, up to you, some salt pepper to taste, and this is the hominy. This is corn that has been, you know, like boiled into pups. So this one, they sell it in cans for the pozole. So let me keep the next step. So for the pozole, we're gonna need a tall saucepan or steamer, you know, the tamaleras. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna fill it up with water, like 3/4 of the pot. Then you're just gonna put your meat, okay? And you're just gonna bring it to boil. So as soon as it starts boiling, we're gonna come back and show you the next step. Okay, so in the meantime, where our pozole is gonna cook for 2 hours, we're gonna make, we have 3 different ways to serve the pozole, okay? White pozole, pozole verde, and pozole rojo, so the green and the red salsas. So I'm gonna show you the sauces that we're gonna need for the classic pozole first, the red pozole, and then I'm gonna make another video with the salsa verde for the pozole. So for the first video, we're gonna need chile guajillo, about 4. This one, it just keeps a color, it's not spicy at all, okay? Chile puya and chile mulato, same thing, you know, they're like sweet, they're not hot. And also we're gonna need bay leaves, about 2 bay leaves, 2 chipotles, dry, and 2 pasilla peppers, okay? Just to give a little kick. But if you want it more spicy, you can always use some chile de árbol, you know, about 3, 4, or as many as you like. If you want to kick it up a little bit more, then you go with the chile piquin. This is the very small chili, but it's really hot, okay? And also we're gonna need a half an onion, some garlic cloves, about 4 garlic cloves, and then I'm gonna show you the next step. Okay, so for our sauce, we're gonna need 2 liters of water. We're gonna put all the chilies in here, you know, as many as you like, on the how spicy you want it. But for this recipe, I put 4 guajillos, 2 mulatos, 2 pasillas, 2 chipotle peppers, dry, the 2 bay leaves, and 4 garlic cloves, okay? And then we're just gonna bring it to boil. We're gonna come back, add some salt and oregano. Okay, so as soon as our sauce starts boiling, our chilies, we're gonna lower the heat to medium high, okay? Then we're gonna add some black pepper to taste, some oregano, about 2 tablespoons, and some salt. And then we're just gonna let it cook for about 10 minutes in a medium high heat or lower heat, and then we're gonna come back and show you the next step. So when your pozole start boiling, we're gonna start removing all these toxins, okay? And we're just gonna let it cook for 1 more hour in a low heat, and then we're gonna come back and finish our pozole. So as soon as your chiles, they're like this, you know, they're all hydrated. So we're gonna put them in the blender, you know, the chile, the everything that we put in the sauce, the onion, the bay leaves, everything. We're just gonna blend them, okay? It's just really, really blend. So we're gonna come back when this is ready and we're gonna strain it. Now we're gonna strain our sauce, okay? So this is how you want your sauce, like that. Make sure you strain it, so that way you don't have any of the skin on or seeds and stuff like that. We're gonna come back and show you the final dish. Okay, so this is how our salsa looks like for the pozole. So this is gonna be for the red pozole. And like I say before, you know, you can make it white, red, or green. So I already give you the recipe for the green pozole. So as soon as this is pozole is ready, I'm gonna show you, you know, what to do next. So we'll see you in a few minutes. So our pozole is almost done. It's been cooking for about an hour and a half. So now we're gonna add the salt, you know, as much as you need or to taste. Oregano, same thing, you know, as much as you need, about 2 tablespoons or so. Then we're gonna add the hominy, okay? And we're just gonna let it cook for about 1 more hour. So, you know, the meat is almost done. See, it's a little hard, but it's almost there. So I would say 1 more hour, and I'll see you in 1 hour. So this is our final dish on the pozole. The meat is already, you know, falling off the meat, the bones. See, it's soft. And I have mine already plated over here. So usually you serve it white because that's the base. And if you want to change it to green, you just gonna put your sauce in, you know, in the pozole, bring it to boil and let it simmer and it's ready. If you want to change it to red, same thing, you know. You just put your sauce, bring it to boil, and you know, it's ready. And then we're gonna serve it with some cabbage, radishes, some avocado, chile de árbol or chili flakes, lemon or lime, and some oregano on the side with your favorite tostadas or chips. And hopefully you guys like this video and these recipes. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow me on Facebook and Snapchat. And I'll see you next time. Thank you. Enjoy. Okay, so if you want to change it to red, same thing. You know, you're just gonna put your sauce as much as you need. Okay. And then just bring it to boil again and let it cool down a little bit or simmer, or you can serve it right away. So hopefully you guys like this recipe, this idea. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Facebook, YouTube, and Snapchat. Thank you. See you next time. Okay, so this is how we have the pozole. We have the white, the green, and the red one. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you. Enjoy.